فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وبعد. Inshallah, I wanted to talk about a topic which is very important. It's needed to be spoken about, and it's a topic that many people they forsake, they leave, they are heedless about. And inshallah, I wanted to bring it to your attention. Inshallah, it's the issue regarding the importance of al-amr bil ma'roof, calling to the good. والنهي عن المنكر and prohibiting the evil. الإمام أبي محمد علي بن محمد الأندلسي, who is known as Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri, he has a book called Al-Fisal fi al-Milal wal-Ahwa wal-Nihal, on the fourth volume, page 171. He says, اتفقت الأمة كلها على وجوب الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر بلا خلاف من أحد منهم. That the Ummah are in of agreement, إجماع of what? All of them, that it is mandatory to call to the good and order it, والنهي عن المنكر and to prohibit the evil, بلا خلاف, without any dispute, من أحد منهم, from any of the scholars and any of the ulama, at the Ummah of Islam. There is no one who disagrees with this. And this is an issue. أكد الله تعالى على وجوبها في مواضع كثيرة من كتابه الكريم. It's an aspect in which Allah affirmed, and He mentions in many places in the Quran. أن وجاءت الأخبار المتواترة, and narrations that are large in its narrators have come from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِدَلَالَةِ عَلَى هَذَا الْوُجُوبِ, that indicate the mandatory of it, كَمَا أَجْبَعَ السَّلَفُ, as the Salaf, the pious predecessors, have also gotten a consensus on this issue, and the fuqaha, the jurisprudent scholars, عَلَى وُجُوبِ الْأَمْرِ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, in calling to the good and prohibiting the evil in it. وَلِذَلِكَ, let's mention some points or evidences to show this. أولا, the first thing is الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر مما أرسل الله به الرسل. It's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophets to call to the good and to prohibit the evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nahl, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. Allah says in this ayah that He sent in every nation a messenger. And يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ, He says to every nation, worship Allah. وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ, and stay far from the طَوَاغِيتِ. الطَّاغُوتِ is كُلُّ مَا عُبِدَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ, everything that is worshipped besides Allah, and who's pleased with it. This is called the طَاغُوتِ. The Prophet Allah Azza wa Jalla said in this verse, that every prophet that came to every nation ordered his people to worship Allah and to abstain from the tawagheed. Al-Imam ibn Kathir rahimahullah, Abu al-Fida, Ismail ibn Kathir, he says, ba'atha fi kulli ummatin ay fi kulli qarnin wa ta'ifatin min an-nas rasulan wa kulluhum yad'una ila ibadati Allah wa yanhawna 'an ibadati ma siwa. Meaning Allah said that in every nation, in every century, and in every group, a messenger. And that messenger called all of them to worship Allah. وَيَنْهَوْنَا, and he prohibited them. عَنْ عِبَادَةِ مَا سِوَاهُ, to what? To prohibit them from worship anything other than Allah. Al-Imam Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, his name is Ahmad ibn Abd al-Halim, ibn Abdullah, ibn Abd al-Salam ibn Abdullah, ابن أبي قاسم ابن تيمية الحراري تقي الدين أبو العباس ابن شهاب الدين, who died the year 661. He said al-amr bil ma'ruf wa nahy 'an al-munkar, to call to the good and prohibit the evil. هو الذي أنزل الله تعالى به كتب. It's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down books. It's for that reason. وأرسل به الرسل. And because of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down messages. وهو من الدين. And it's from the religion. الأمر بالمعروف عن المنكر. فالله تعالى أرسل رسول عليه السلام. Allah sent down messages and prophets للأمر بالتوحيد, to call the people to the monotheism of the توحيد. والنهي عن عبادة الطاغوت, and to stay away from worshiping the طواغيت. And that is الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. The second thing to show you is standing up for أمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر من أوصاف سيد المرسلين. It was the characteristics of Muhammad ibn Abdullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. It was the characteristics Allah described him as. Allah said in the Quran, in regards to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, Surah Al-A'raf, الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل. Allah is saying, الذين يتبعون, those who follow, الرسول, the Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, النبي, the Prophet, الأمي, the one that could not write nor read, الذين يجدون, الذي يجدون, the one that they find, مكتوباً, he's, it's written, his name, his characteristics, how he was written in their books, meaning Torah, and also in Injil. What was his characteristics? يأمرهم بالمعروف, he will call them to the good. وينهاهم عن المنكر, and he will prohibit them from the evil. ويحل لهم الطيبات, and he will permit for them that which is halal, that's permissible, عليهم. ويحل لهم الطيبات, ويحرم عليهم الخبائث, and he will prohibit from them الخبائث, the evil things. ويضع عنهم, and he will also take off them إسرهم, hardship. والأغلال التي كانت عليهم, and the chains that they were shackled in. فالذين آمنوا, the ones who believed in him. وعزروه, who gave him support. ونصروه, who gave him support and help. واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه, and they followed the light that was with him. أولئك هم المفلحون, those are the ones who are successful. يقول الحافظ ابن كثير, الإمام ابن كثير says in his كتاب لتفسير in regards to this ayah رحمه الله تعالى, حول هذه الآية in regards to this verse, يأمرهم بالمعروف, he calls them to the good, وينهاهم عن المنكر, and he prohibits them from evil. هذه صفة الرسول الكريم, this is the description of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم في الكتب المتقدمة, in the books that preceded us, meaning التوراة والإنجيل. وهكذا, and like that, كانت حاله عليه السلام, and it was also his situation صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يأمره, he would not order إلا بخير except good, ولا ينهى, and he would not prohibit them إلا عن شر except from evil. إذن الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر was a characteristics of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam.